She called to Ozga and Shaggy to wade across, assuring them the water was shallow and would not wet them. At once they followed her advice, avoiding the rubber stepping stones, and made the crossing with ease. This encouraged the entire party to wade through the dry water, and in a few minutes all had assembled on the bank and renewed their journey along the path that led to the Nome King's dominions. When Kaliko again looked through his magic spyglass, he exclaimed, "Bad luck, Your Majesty! All the invaders have passed the rubber country, and now are fast approaching the entrance to your caverns." Ruggedo raved and stormed at the news, and his anger was so great that several times, as he strode up and down his jeweled cavern, he paused to kick Kaliko upon his shins, which were so sensitive that the poor gnome howled with pain. Finally the king said, "There's no help for it. We must drop these audacious invaders down the hollow tube." Kaliko gave a jump at this, and looked at his master wonderingly. "If you do that, Your Majesty," he said, "you will make Tititi Hoochoo very angry."
"Never mind that," retorted Ruggedo. "Tititi Hoochoo lives on the other side of the world, so what do I care for his anger?"
Kaliko shuddered and uttered a little groan.
"Remember his terrible powers," he pleaded, "and remember that he warned you the last time you slid people through the hollow tube that if you did it again, he would take vengeance upon you."
The Metal Monarch walked up and down in silence, thinking deeply. "Of two dangers," said he, "it is wise to choose the least."
"What do you suppose these invaders want?"